turned into an easy first down conversion.
Fields throw complete here to Kmet. He'll get it inside the 20. Touchdown! Cole Kmet, 48 yards. And the Bears are on the board first here in Vegas.
Santos with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Here's Abdullah from his end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On second and 10, Carr. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A Raider first down, 17 yards. Now Carr. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Throwing his car on third down. Looking right sideline, that's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 44-yard line. Now Carr. Rush coming, and he's taken down. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down. From midfield, here's Carr. Under pressure, they got him again.
Dropped for a loss of 7 by multiple defenders.
So now make that a second sack for them on this drive.
And Brandon, we hear it every week when we go out to do a game. Everyone talks about playing complimentary football. Their offense goes down and scores. They see that, and they want to back them up, and that they did, getting 2 sacks on this first drive.
A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for 4th. They'll go for it. It's Carr. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. The Raiders try it on 4th down, but to no avail. And the Bears will get the football back. The Bears in good field position to start out 1st and 10 at their 36-yard line. Play action, Fields locates Claypool on the crossing route, and he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Fields. Jones has it. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. They'll try the middle with Montgomery. And they get to him quickly here as he stops right around the 13. Bringing him down defensively, Jayon Brown.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
On second and 9, Fields. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Max Crosby came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The Fields is off, and on comes Cairo Santos for the Chicago field goal. And this a 39-yard attempt. And that hits off the left upright, and it caroms away, no good. And this will remain a one-touchdown game.
Trying to build on that opening drive touchdown, but the drive stalls out. And then you get the missed field goal here, so they wind up with nothing to show from drive number 2.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And he'll earn a couple of tough yards past the 30 to the 31.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback on the expected passing situation.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. 3 yards is the gain that time, second and goal.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to win.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bears are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Here's Abdullah from his end zone. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay.
There he goes, left side. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. They were already down 2 scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies a big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed because, let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over. This game could be 88 and out the gate early.
88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. Usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10. At their own 14-yard line.
To throw is Fields. Wesco, the tight end, making the catch. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
On first and 10, here's Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down for the Bears.
Well, normally you see three tight ends in a formation. You have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run. And I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. It looks like a loss of right around 11 there on first down to set him back on second. They're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Here's Fields. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. So they take the flag and the yardage that comes with it. Fields on first down. He'll get this underneath to Montgomery. Finding room at midfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run, good for 24 yards. Now a first down throw, Fields. Montgomery, another target and catch. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
And these back-to-back catches here out of the backfield, that can set something up downfield in a later sequence, right?
A lot of the time, it starts to draw the defense closer to the line of scrimmage. So to your point, show this swing pass, show this check down, maybe later on you heave one deep when you catch him close to the spot.
Third and two, Fields. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. They're able to keep the drive alive, 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. So they convert on fourth, and now from just outside the 30, here's first and 10. And he fires one that's intercepted. And the Raiders are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. And then you give up the touchdown on the last drive. Now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much because, as you noted, things change. Now they've got to go out there and get a spark going again and try and slow down this comeback. Well, they obviously read man coverage their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him think. Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then curls back inside for the completion.
And they're going to get this up to midfield. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Trotty! Five, and they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown. Charles, he was looking for just a short throw, kept it in range for the rare linebacker pick six.
And give him full credit for his focus. He just kept the quarterback in his sights, and where he was looking to throw, he positioned himself perfectly to be there for the interception. He made the play of the game for his defense right there.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, we'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Raiders are going to have it first, and they trail here as we get back to it in this third quarter of action. Here's Abdullah from his end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 22. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And he comes back with one complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Carr out of throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Eddie Jackson picks it, and the Bears are going to take possession of the football.
As they started that drive, I think they looked at the scoreboard and said, this is a manageable deficit, guys, but let's go ahead and start cutting it down right here. Instead, an interception happened, so a two-possession game might become three. So as we get going here in the second half, this could rapidly reach the point where there isn't enough time left for a comeback if their defense doesn't bail them out.
An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
Here's Fields.
And he's got Mooney in the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. 10 yards on the touchdown pass. And the Bears have moved out in front by three touchdowns. Santos with the extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away.
Abdullah's going to stay put, and the drive will start at the 25.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
After the sack on first down, Carr. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Matthew Adams.
And they will score. Pick six for a Bears touchdown. Now the point after try for Santos. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
And Abdullah will not try to bring it out.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home? To their final destination.
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Another try after the first down sack. Carr, he'll find his tight end. That's Waller. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. That was a corner blitz, and it was Kyler Gordon getting in there for the sack.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming.
And now here is another interception. Kyler Gordon picks it off, and the Bears will take over possession here up at the 44. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 44. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. A throw left side taken in by Kmet. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36. Charles, you talk so much about quick change plays. There's one right there. You get the turnover and boom, hit him with a big one.
And defenses plan for this all the time. They work on it in practice. But in the middle of the game, when that quick change takes place, oftentimes guys aren't as focused as they need to be.
Third quarter from Southern Nevada. Here's a second and 10. Back to throw. Fields. Flushed out right. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. Maybe worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's third and long. Now it's Fields. Man open here is Jones. Touchdown, Bears! Valus Jones. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Bears get another third-quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. A familiar refrain, a turnover leads to a touchdown, and that lead grows even wider now here in this third quarter.
Yeah, partner, I'd say there's a lot of grins breaking out on that sideline because, let's face it, they came in thinking they were in for a real fight in this game, but this one's been about as one-sided as we've seen in a while. In addition, if you're a backup, time to start stretching and loosening up. You may get some playing time in this one.
The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away. Abdul is going to stay put, and the drive will start at the 25. Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
First down, Carr.
Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack.
Multiple defenders get to him there, and that is the sixth time he's been sacked in this ball game. But collectively as a defense, Charles, I think if you get four sacks a game, you're feeling really good. Now they have six as a unit.
And that type of a number?
Under pressure, and they got to him again. Call it a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jalen Johnson.
All I can do up here is just shake my head. Six interceptions. I cannot imagine what he's thinking between the ears right now.
Well, just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated. And if you're a receiver, you're thinking to yourself, any ball that's in the air, you become receiver and defensive back. You've got to go compete for the ball so you don't get another one picked off.
Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Fields now to throw. That one tipped, and it's incomplete. What good hands there defensively. That's second down. Their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns. And it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
Throwing again is Fields.
Yeah, he's got it.
And the Bears are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Well, there's absolutely been no stopping this offense today. They already have the big lead, obviously. Here in the fourth quarter, they could coast to the end, but right now they're not passing up any chance.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears.
David Montgomery,
his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Bears add 6 more to their point total, and they're on cruise control right now here in the fourth. When coaches come into a game preaching total team effort,
yeah, should I style not for you, but it's for me.